Welcome back, troopers and Star Wars fans, to another exciting episode of Trop Stop, and today we're diving into the deep heart of the Clone Wars and uncovering one of the most intense and lesser-known battles, the Battle of Umbara. Get ready for a gripping story of bravery and sacrifice as we explore this treacherous conflict. Let's jump in. The Battle of Umbara, a fierce and pivotal engagement that unfolded on the shadowy planet of Umbara. Hidden beneath its dense forest and eerie atmosphere, struggle for control raged between the Republic's 501st Legion, led by General Anakin Skywalker, and the Separatist forces under the command of General Pon Carell. Today we're going to look into a step-by-step process on how the 501st adapted to the forest on Umbara, and how they eventually oversaw it and ended up arresting the Separatist leader, Pon Carell. Let's get into it. Day 1. The Republic's 501st Legion, led by Captain Rex, is deployed to the planet Umbara to assist in the campaign to liberate it from the Separatist control. The clone troopers faced resilience from the Umbaran militia, which is allied with the Separatists. Rex and his troopers do face challenges adapting to the unique environment and the elusive tactics of the Umbarans.
Must be going on.
Master Krell, my thanks for the air support.
Indeed, General Skywalker. The locals have proven to be more resourceful than we anticipated.
But that's not the reason for your visit.
No. The Council has ordered you back to Coruscant, effective immediately.
What? Why?
I'm afraid a request was made by the Supreme Chancellor, and the Council obliged. That is all they would tell me.
Well, I can't just leave my men.
I'll be taking over in the interim.
Don't worry about a thing, sir. We'll have the city under Republic control by the time you're back. On the city's defenses.
There won't be any need, Captain.
Sir?
All platoons will execute a forward assault along the main route to the city.
But, sir, General Skywalker's plan was to surprise them with multiple attacks. If we come in from the main route, they're likely to engage us in a full frontal assault.
Change of plans, Captain. I'm in command now.
With all due respect, General, we don't know what we are up against. It might be wiser to think first.
Are you questioning my order? This battalion will take the main road, straight to the capital. You will not stop, and you will not turn back regardless of the resistance you meet. We will attack them with all our troops, not some sneak attack with a few men. That is my order, and you will follow it explicitly. Do I make myself clear, CT-7567?
Yes, General.
Now engage!
Day 2, Captain Rex receives conflicting orders from his Jedi General, Pon Carell, leading to the confusion and tension among the clone troopers. Rex discovers that Carell's decisions seem to prioritize achieving victory at any cost, even if it means sacrificing the lives of his own men. The clone troopers continue to engage in intensive battles with the Umbaran forces, both in the forest and the urban areas.
All's this down. So's Ringo. Can you sweep them?
They're more over here. Looks like the whole road's been booby-trapped.
Everyone, watch your step.
Day 3. Rex and his troopers uncover evidence that suggests General Krell may be secretly working for the Separatist. The clone troopers begin to question their loyalty to Krell and the Republic, as they struggle to reconcile their duty with the suspicions. As the battle escalates, Rex and his troopers find themselves fighting not only against the enemy, but also against their own Jedi General.
Surrender, General.
You're committing mutiny, Captain.
Explain your actions.
My actions?
For ordering your troops against one another.
Oh, that. I'm surprised you were able to figure it out for a clone.
Surrender, General. You're outnumbered.
You dare to attack a Jedi!
Thank you.
Day 4, Captain Rex confronts General Krell about his apparent betrayal, leading to a tense confrontation. The clone troopers must make difficult decisions about their allegiances and the best course of action to protect their brothers and fulfill their duty. Rex, alongside with the other loyal troopers, stages a mutiny against General Krell's command, recognizing the need to stop this treachery. On Day 5, the clone troopers now united against their rogue Jedi General, and they launch a final assault on the Umbaran capital. They face fierce resistance from Umbaran forces and Separatist droids, but Jedi General Obi-Wan Kenobi arrives to assist Rex and his troopers, providing crucial support to the battle. In conclusion, the Republic forces emerge victorious, successfully liberating Umbara from Separatist control. The Battle of Umbara highlights the bravery and resilience of the clone troopers, as well as the complexities and challenge they face in the midst of the Clone Wars. Ultimately, the Republic forces emerge victorious, liberating Umbara from the grip of the Separatists. The Battle of Umbara showcased the resilience and heroism of the clone troopers and their ability to adapt to hostile environments and their unwavering dedication to the Republic's cause. And that wraps up our journey through the Battle of Umbara, troopers. Join us next time on Chop Stop as we uncover more hidden gems from the Star Wars universe. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to stay tuned for more exciting content. This is Chop Stop signing off, and may the Force be with you. We'll be right back.